Hello Android developers, my name is Mohsen and today I want to talk about 10 tips for having a good Git commit and pull request. Before we start, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already and turn on the notification bell to get informed when there is a new video. Let's start. Number 1. Follow the single responsibility principle. Avoid falling down the rabbit holes. Commit changes should be single responsible. Focus on what you are working on while working on a feature and overcome the temptation to change or refactor codes. One suggestion is to create a list of your findings, so first, free your mind by writing it down and second, to be able to share it with your teammates later. For sharing purposes, you can also create a TechTap Jira ticket or GitHub issue to make it more transparent. Number 2. Commit message should speak for itself. Always keep in mind that with your commit message or pull request description, you are talking to another human and you are not coding anymore. You are writing a history for the future developers. Then make sure your commit message are short, clean and self-explanatory. Your commit messages should also have the potential to become your pull request description without any changes and get your reviewer's approval. Git commit messages has a first line which is being called subject and the rest which are details. The subject should complete this sentence short and right to the point. This commit will, for instance, remove deprecated method X. Release version 1.0. Refactor feature X for more readability. The detail part should include what your commit does, why you're doing it, like ticket or issue number, and how it is done. Your team may also agree on a predefined template for both commit messages and pull requests that you can add to your project Git repo. Number 3. Feature breaking. As a rule of thumb, short pull requests get faster and higher quality reviews. Studies show that a pull request shouldn't go higher than 250 lines of code changes to receive a fast and high quality review. Therefore, break your feature into smaller working parts. It means they shouldn't break the build or the app functionality. Another positive point about small changes is that they get merged fast and this avoids keeping a branch for a long time and as a result no merge conflicts. Number 4. Automate everything using continuous integration, also known as CI. Every commit should build independently from other commits. By setting up a CI service like GitHub Actions, make sure your commit builds and all unit tests are passing and you didn't break a thing. Add Android Lint, KT Lint, Detect, and any other services that validates your code quality to make sure you keep the code quality as it was before and it improves as you move forward. Number 5. Level up your pull request with screenshots. If you're working on a feature that has a UI, then why not adding some screenshots of your great job to your pull request descriptions? This way, the reviewers also get on board faster about what you changed and how it looks like. You can also go further and add some animated GIF files if your UI has an animation. Number 6. Integration with ticket and issues. GitHub issues or Jira tickets come with repo integration, which means you can refer to their IDs and they get informed which commit is related to the issue or ticket. You can also go further with integration and use keywords like fix or close to close an issue or move a ticket forward to the next stage in the workflow. Number 7. Merge, rebase, and squash. Your branch can be merged, rebased, or squashed to the main branch. I don't want to go deep with the pros and cons of every method, but I suggest come to an agreement with your team and keep doing it. You can also choose a branching strategy like Git flow or trunk-based development, or even come up with a solution that works for your team or your project and follow to have a way of doing things and make sure everyone is on board and doing the same thing. Number 8. Emojis speak louder than words. The pull request review usually happen async, and emojis are a cool way to express feeling about what you are talking about. Also, you can use them in reaction to what a reviewer suggested. Meanwhile, your team can also agree on defining a special meaning for some emojis. For instance, a light bulb means an improvement suggestion that is not a blocker from the reviewer's perspective. Also, don't be afraid to show your excitement about your colleague's fantastic job with a nice animated GIF. Number 9. Explain before being asked. Some commit might need some explanation about edge cases and what issue you faced while doing the task, and why you decide to do it this way. You already did the changes. That means you as the commit author should know exactly which part of the code needs some details about why and how you did it, to give some insight and make the review process faster and easier. So be smart and open some info discussions on your pull request lines and explain those edge cases before a reviewer asks. Number 10. Talk with your teammates. To have some ground rules that everyone agrees on and be on the same page, set up a meeting and talk about what fits the most for your team and your project. Also, don't be afraid to review the rules that are already introduced by older developers. I also suggest adding a Git convention to your repos README to be able to refer to and also make the life for the new team members easier. Bonus tip. If you are a standalone developer with no teammates to review your commit, you can use this trick I used before, which may sound nonsense, but it works. Apply your changes and open the pull request, but leave it there and review it by yourself the other day with a fresh mind. I assure you will always find a point to improve the other day. Also, you can use the rubber duck debugging solution for code review by explaining what you did to a dummy duck or even talking about it to another developer who is not even an Android developer, or going further and explain it to a non-developer colleague like a QA team member. Hope you found these points useful. Please write in the comments which points you are already doing on daily basis and which points you will try in the future. Plus, also share if you already have other rules or tricks in your team that improved your commits and pull requests code review quality. I will add multiple links to different articles related to the points I talked about to the video descriptions, so you can study more if you are interested. See you soon in another Android development tips and tricks video. Bye!